Welcome back to another review, and today I'm gonna take a look at the Rococo mocap suit, and I can't show it to you right now because it's still in the box, so let's go to the unboxing. But before I unbox it, I want to say thank you to Rococo. They sent me the Smart Suit Pro so I can review it and check it all out. So thank you so much. This is a sponsor review then. And also thank you for their patience. They sent it to me a long time ago. I just was really busy, but now I have time. I can't wait to test it out. So over at cameras, everything's on. Let's check it out. Let's take out the label. It comes in a box like this. There's a bunch of stuff in it. Here you got Rococo Smart Suit Pro. Very shiny, and if you open that up, here is the suit, branding there, but more about the suit later. All right, I made some room here. I don't know what this is, but you get this in here. Ooh, you get a, it's gonna say a regular coat hanger, but it's very soft to the touch. It's a very special coating on here. It's like a high premium coat hanger. You got that, you got your USB to USB-C cable by Anker. Welcome to the Rococo community. Thank you so much. This is a getting started paper. Just imagine more paperwork. Ooh, got stickers and more stickers. That is what's in the box. What is this? This must be a protective cover for once the suit is out. Got the handle, got your logo here. Snaps open and must snap open to open up the whole thing. Look at that, ooh. Got all of these little zipper pouches here. Here's the whole thing. So I would assume that's pretty cool. Coat hanger right there. Back up here. Snap, snap, and there you go. That's pretty cool though. It's good when you have to travel around and take your places, but let's get back to the suit. Here's the Smart Suit Pro cover. That is the suit and all the components in this box. I don't know if you buy it, if you get the same thing. Since this is a review unit, I don't know if I got something else, but this is what I got. This is what's in my box. But I'm very curious about the fit. So I got a specific size. This is a large. I think I got a large. I know I'm a large. I don't know. But there's not enough room for this here. So I'm going to go to the other room, the other office room area. Put the suit on so you can see the whole thing. And then after that, the series will continue with a installation how-to. There's going to be a stress test, different applications and what to do and some surprises. So there's a lot that I want to cover with this suit. It's going to be a series, maybe 8, 9, 10, a lot of clips. I have so many ideas. I can't wait. Let's get out of here so I can put the suit on. All right. I'm in the other room now, clearly. That is the suit. Hope it fits. Not because they sent me the wrong version, but it's been some time since I got it and I've been eating a lot of chocolate. But before I put it on, I'm so concerned about dog hair. Black t-shirt, black suit. But before I do, I wanna make sure I put it on the right way, but also wanna show you the website and just a general overview before I go through all the testing. Let's switch over to the website. So if you go to the Rococo website, here it is. Motion capture, made, mobile, personal, easy. That's their branding. They got their gloves here. This is the Discover the Smart Suit Pro. So this is what I got. I got the Smart Suit Pro. It starts at $2,495. Now, this may sound steep, but there are a lot of competitors out there. They're much more expensive, but this is actually more on the cheaper side. That is the site here. You can see lots of behind the scenes magic, as they say here. You can see that it has sensors, so 19 inertial sensors, which is important because different studios and different setups use different technology. This is more of a inertia-based mocap suit versus if you go somewhere where you have trackers and cameras, you go to your T-pose and you start your capturing, this might be all be captured with your character at the origin. So if you take that data and put it into some software, you might have to adjust the data and where your character animation is into the center. And that's a whole different thing I'm gonna cover over multiple series, just as a heads up. So this is a inertia-based motion capture suit. The suit comes in small, medium, and large, and extra large. I believe I got a large. There is a 6 hours of battery time, has Wi-Fi. This is all operated through Wi-Fi. You can export these as FBX, BVH, and CSV, and it does real-time streaming at 100 frames per second. You can go here for all the specs here. So you can go down, I put the link in the description. This is your sizing guide. Feel free to check that out. Here's the sensor, talks about the hub. battery and power. The suit is powered by an external power bank. See our recommendations here. You connect the suit via the USB power cables in the box. There's nothing to click here, so see our recommendations here. There's nothing here. That is the wireless information, and this is what the box has, right? You got the cables, the bag, and the suit like I showed you. Also, it's waterproof. Okay, it's not water resistant. My first thought was, I can jump into the pool and do some underwater motion capture, do some Avatar style underwater motion. No, it's waterproof, just in case, you know, it's rain or something, which is cool though, because I want to take it outside and do a stress test as well. Not in terms of waterproofness, is that a word? But in terms of how far the sensors work and distance and running, all kind of stuff. But again, that's in future parts. So software and plugins, it supports all of these. Unreal, Unity, Blender, Maya, Mobu, Houdini, Cinema 4D, and iClone. And you can download the plugins here. That actually works. You go over here, and this is the IO framework. You can get all information and all the plugins here. I'm gonna check that out later. Let's go back. Maintenance. The electronic parts can be easily removed from the smart suit, so you can wash the whole thing. So as you do your sessions, you're gonna be moving around. Probably will be sweaty, although it seems like it's a breathable mesh. It's not like I haven't worn it yet, but it doesn't seem like it's a you know, trash bag type of suit where you put it on and you're just sweaty. So there's a lot of thought put into the suit. But again, just in case you want to wash it, you can take that off, take all the cables out, and just wash the suit. 30-day satisfaction guarantee. I've had this for months now, so the 30-day is gone. But again, thank you so much, Rococo. Massively patient. I had this for months, like I said, but so much came up at work and teaching. I didn't have time. I finally have time. I'm so excited as I'm reading this. I just want to test it out. Let's continue. Back to the side, you can go down here. It explains to you the complete real-time pipeline. Connect with Smart Suit Pro, connect with Wi-Fi, edit in Rococo Studio, and stream all your data. This is going to be awesome. Again, plugins, what's included. You can book a free online demo. This is the Rococo Studio, and this is really cool. The full performance capture. So they have smart gloves. I don't have the smart gloves with me, but I was told that they will be sending a smart glove for review purposes as well. I don't know when, but check out my channel, subscribe so you're up to date, because it's going to come. I don't know yet when, but I can't wait to test that one out. I got lots of ideas for finger tracking. And then obviously the Smart Suit Pro. And there's also face capture. That's going to be interesting too. Read more. So face your creativity, pun intended. $695 for all of that. Feel free to check out the sites. I'm going to go and go quickly through this here. You can see what this is. It kind of repeats it, but I'm going to check that out at a later point. And that is that. You can choose a bundle. So let's look at the bundle offerings. You have hand, body, and face. That is the total for that. You have body and fingers only. There's body and face. There's also a free online demo here. There's also face and fingers. And again, the free online demo. Lots of options. And you can see up here, this is the Smart Suit Pro, Smart Gloves, Face Capture Studio, and the Motion Library Pages. So this is something I'm gonna check out later on. You can download data, do all kinds of stuff. I can't wait to check this out. It's gonna be so cool. Now, set up in less than a minute, the Smart Suit Pro is completely intuitive to wear and use. Famous last words, I'm gonna try this on. If I can put it on without any problems, then I know you can as well. So let's put the suit on. Full suit, as you can see. It's comfy. Halfway through, it's not too bad. Okay. Definitely snug. Ugh. Wasn't that bad. It's definitely snug. Gotta rethink my diet. Now, there's more to it too. So you can take these and tighten it if you want to. This is already fairly snug there. You got the sensors in here. This is your long zipper that you can open. So if you want to wash this, but again, you can tighten this if you want. This is obviously on both sides. You got your, umbilical cord power here. Little pockets. Tightening of the waist, not needed. Same thing for the legs. Tightening strap here. Both sides, of course. Goes without saying, but I know, that's why I mention it. You got a calf strap as well. I found the dog hair. And last but not least, I don't know if it's last, but there's also the feet. Let me switch over to my phone. I'm sure there's a much easier way to do all this, but I got this all set up really like this. All right, here's the foot. All right, this goes over, and then you got your strap here, tighten that. Here's the sensor. This will all make sense in the edit. That's the suit. Fuck, stretchy. Yeah, it's actually nice. You can do all kinds of stuff here. It's fairly breathable. I mean, I'm warm-ish from the movement and other problems, but yeah, it's comfy. I like it. Now, there is a head piece here to track your head, which is in the back. Now, I knew that. The reason why I put it on first, just to show you, if you do this and you forget, sometimes like on like surf suits, whatever, you have a longer, like a cord on the zipper so that you can grab it and open it up like this. You don't have that here. So make sure you open it up so that everything is ready to go as you want to put it on. So you cannot put this on and put this on later on. This has to be a two-person job, or you open it up before you put on the suit. Unless you're really flexible, which I'm not. So let's show you the headpiece. So you don't have to take the whole thing off. You just unzip it, sit down, open the back, take this out, zip it back up, put the suit back on. And you can see here, actually. So you got meshy areas, breathability. You can see this here. It's actually all throughout here, also through armpits. Then you can grab it. And there you go. Almost reminds me of Dune. You gotta put that in there, then never mind. This is a one-piece headband. So you got the sensor here. That is your stretchy material, but there's nothing to zip. So put this on your head, and that's that. So if you have a different head, or you might have to, I don't know, maybe you wear something, maybe a hat or a helmet. So there is a limit to this. It's fairly big though. I don't want to break it here, but it should be okay for multiple applications. Again, if you have a helmet or a suit or something, I don't know. I don't know why you never record with a helmet. You never know, but there is extra room. It could be interesting to have this like these, where you can actually take it off and make it extra big, extra small. That could be one thing potentially. I don't know, just a thought. Also, I've never worn a mocap suit like this, so I have no frame of comparison. So as a first time newbie user, this seems really comfortable. Upon first glance, it seems really well made. Again, I haven't used this before. I don't know if you have a year of constant moving and trying things out, if seams start to break, I don't know. This will be, as I said, a multiple series testing. Not, you have to wait a whole year, but I'm gonna do multiple clips about stress testing, not just the software, but also the suit. And I'll come back to it. I'll come back in a year and say, hey, it's been a year. Been doing this, you know, I'm using this suit. What holds up? Is anything breaking? Yes or no? It seems really cool. And again, these are neat because you need to tighten these so that your sensors don't move. Everything has to be snug so that when you do quick moves, you don't have anything of some wiggly sensor there. So take these, tighten them up. It's all very cool. Put them back there. Obviously in the head. It's the back of the head. I'm assuming back of the head, to be honest. I just put this on because the cable's back there. I don't think you're gonna have to turn this to the front. I could be wrong. First time usage, I'm gonna research if that is true or not, and I'll tell you in part two. Like you saw on the website, there is no power supply, right? That comes with it. I'm assuming for, I don't know, shipping reasons, or, you know, could explode, whatever it is. So this doesn't come with it, but you got your cable here. So I'm gonna check out my power banks and then power the suit up, but that's part two. So stick around for the future parts. And if you don't want to miss them, you can feel free to subscribe if you want to, so you get the notification. And if you hit that bell, so that you know I uploaded a new clip. So this is going to be part one, part two, up to part 8, 9, 10. Lots of ideas. Can't wait to do them all. That is that. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in part two.